So I'm Dr. Alicia Zenhauser, but my patients call me Dr. Zen for short. I'm a naturopathic doctor in Scottsdale, Arizona. So we really focus on preconception, fertility, and postpartum care. So really women's health, but kind of taking a proactive approach. When I saw patient after patient who didn't really know what to do after getting off of birth control, who felt kind of lost, who were kind of told, okay, if I'm under 35, just go and try to have a baby. And if it doesn't happen, come back to me. And that wasn't the world that I really wanted to work with. I really wanted to take more of that preventative and proactive approach. I really wanted it to really be focused on fertility instead of infertility. What can we do today? Our diet, our lifestyle, our sleep, our environment. So I really help patients kind of get their cycle back on track so they're kind of ready for pregnancy. I still see quite a few patients during even IVF treatment, so helping them support every cycle that they go through. So definitely if you're noticing, hey, I'm not getting an LH surge like all throughout the month, what can I be doing? It's first really important to know what is that root cause, because the treatment will be a little bit different. If it's because your testosterone levels are very elevated and that's affecting your ability to ovulate, then we have to address that testosterone. Maybe actually it's stress related. And a lot of patients will say, okay, like my doctor said, I just have to calm down and, you know, like I will get pregnant. Of course, those wordings are like, no woman wants to hear that ever. But the idea behind it is true in a way. So that's BBT, cervical mucus, and then also ovulation predictor kits, so LH. So I like to use all three because it really provides us a good indicator of all three things that are happening. Just like the example of if you have a fever, well, the basal body temperature is now a little bit off. What do I do? So typically we're also using these measures month after month. So we're looking for a trend more so than a specific date. So it's really important to use these key indicators prior to pregnancy. Kind of, I really like patients to start 3 to 6 months before they want to have a baby so they have an idea what their normal version is. If you have PCOS, so polycystic ovarian syndrome, actually luteinizing hormone is going to be a little bit more accurate than estrogen level markings. To kind of have in a timed intercourse is going to be the day that you get a positive reading and the 24 hours after. Bye everyone!